First up, let's just talk about these initial jobless claims. It does look like a worse number than anticipated for the new claims coming in. Those continuing claims coming down a little bit, and that's some progress. Steve said he wouldn't read too much into one number. How about you?
I wouldn't, but I think we really have to put this in perspective that none of these numbers are good. Anything approaching or close to a million new claims in any individual week is unprecedented for our economy, and to see it persistently now over several months is a bit dispiriting for where our economy is going. I think what I'd like to see is some sort of trajectory in these unemployment claims that would tell us something about recovery or whether the situation is getting worse. It seems as if we're sort of treading water around a million a week, and so it doesn't seem to have any sort of direction for the past several weeks of claims.
What are you watching aside from just the jobless claims? Because obviously you need to, just a moment, Steve, obviously you need to look at a lot of different places.
I think the things that I'm tracking, because I think they're important for the macroeconomy, are consumer spending, consumption, the number of consumers who are in, we would call, debt distress. In other words, they're not sure that they're going to be able to make a rent payment, an auto loan payment, people who will be going into default. Those would be things to really watch. We still have a consumption-based economy, and we want to make sure that that consumption base continues, that households in general, even if they're experiencing unemployment, are able to continue to consume and meet their basic needs. That's probably the first thing that you're checking for financial distress and also for just the health of the economy overall.
Hey, Steve, sorry, it's hard to do this with the delay without stepping on each other. What was your point?
Sorry about that. The professor made me think of a couple of reasons that we could be seeing. Again, early days, you don't want to draw too much from it, but you did have the roll-off of the PPP program. That's something that kept people employed. Right. Wonder if you're seeing some impact from that. The second thing, again, the professor reminded me of this, is you've had the end of that stimulus. I think we're now in the third week of that extra $600 federal benefit rolling off or not being present. And I wonder if there's an impact on that, on the businesses that survived in terms of laying off workers that were benefiting from the extra stimulus that was out there from the federal government. I just want to throw those two thoughts out there about the impact of the lack of stimulus.
That's an excellent point, Professor. We have been kind of watching to see what happens at the end of this. And so far, if you're looking at the retailers, they haven't seen it yet. But do you think that those two stimulus plans coming to an end are starting to have an impact?
You know, eventually they're going to have a bite because of the size of those stimulus programs. And I think if you start looking and projecting ahead, we're towards the second half of August. The airlines have announced that they're likely to have massive layoffs come October. And that will also, of course, have an impact. So when we think about some of these programs, either industry specific or the ones that were broader like the PPP, eventually they're going to have to show up into consumption because these households don't have other resources. We know that disproportionately the households who are experiencing unemployment tend to have less of a cushion, and they're likely running out now that we're 3 weeks behind. Even President Trump's revised stimulus and unemployment extension probably won't roll out for several weeks and will only have a few weeks of support. So we really can't bank on that in terms of having a stimulative effect that would be persistent.